Bhatt, joint MD of Prabhudas, Lilladher, joins in to discuss the fundamentals of the market. But before the market, Dilip Bhatt is with us, like I mentioned. Dilip, hi, over to you then. Tell us, are you buying or selling Sun Pharma and what's the news there?
Well, I think the pharma, which had a good tailwind in terms of the rupee depreciation, possibly is now wearing off. And I think this quarterly results also, the way most of this frontline pharma have played out, it appears that the recovery is still a couple of quarters away very easily. I think except for Divi's, which has shown very strong results, I think most of them are still floundering based on whatever happened to them in the past. So I think as far as Sun Pharma is concerned, yes, you can think about take completely contrarian view that maybe next 3 to 4 quarters it may not go anywhere, but still on a risk return basis the downside appears to be limited. So as a defensive portfolio you may think about buying, but not certainly not for any proactive gains that you may be thinking about. But Sun Pharma at the moment from our perspective still is a little wait and watch.
Dilip, hi, morning. What about Yes Bank?
Prashant, I think as far as Yes Bank is concerned, unfortunately there are too many news which has an overwhelming impact on the stock, which refuses to go away, some of this news, and they keep on coming very frequently, very periodically. So I think given that complete situation that we are into, I think Yes Bank at best, I think once again there is no need to be in a hurry to buy this stock, though it looks very attractive and it may give certain good sudden spurts and sudden big rises. But given the scenario in which we are operating at the moment, I think it's better to wait and watch and not be in a hurry to buy Yes Bank at the moment.
What about metal stocks? Are you becoming more cautious on them?
Well, I think as far as the metals are concerned, yes, one be a little more careful on the commodities without any doubt, because they have become a little more uncertain and a little more volatile. But in the Indian perspective, and given the production and given the tariffs that exist in India at the moment, I think Tata Steel still appears to be a good play in the metal space. And I would say that something like Jindal Steel and Power also appears to be pretty good. And maybe I would also think that Vedanta, but I think in the pecking order, it would still be Tata Steel and Jindal Steel.
Okay. Dilip, what else is really priority in terms of, you know, top of the mind for you at this point? Absolute returns.
Well, I think the infra space appears to be the one led by Larsen & Toubro. I think that is the space which has been where there is good amount of orders which most of the companies have, and execution is also beginning to pick up in a very serious way. So I think infra companies should merit a look the way they have come off from their highs. So I would look at infra space something like Larsen & Toubro, Nagarjuna Constructions. I think they look pretty interesting. Sadbhav looks pretty decent. I think there's a stock called RPP Infra that also looks pretty good. I think some of these stocks on a risk return basis and also based on their growth and their performance looks pretty interesting.
PSU banks, they might get fresh funding from the government. We still don't know how much, maybe by December. Do you think that maybe there could be that this capital injection could be enough to sustain them through maybe next year? And what would your hope be in terms of asset quality as well?
So, well, I think this injection of funds and the infusion of funds should give some leg up to the PSU banks in the short run. But I think the moot question still which everybody will be having is that whether the NPAs, I mean, we all agree that the worst of the the worst of the NPAs are really over at the moment and there could be some recovery. But on a secular basis, I think the PSU banks will still be under the shadow of what it has done in the past and how it has delivered in terms of the performance. So I think the PSU banks will still not be the ones which everybody will be really looking for, except for maybe State Bank of India, where I think one can still think about a long-term bet. But other PSU banks, I think it would be one would prefer to buy some of the private sector banks.
Okay, Dilip, it's a pleasure as always. Thanks very much for joining in running us through what you make of things there. A lot of stocks on the move, and we discussed a few of them there with Dilip. You know, just